Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yesh Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 8th of September. India, China accuse each other of firing in the air on tense border. Protests continue in Pakistan-administered Kashmir against illegal construction of dams. And Sri Lanka seas has better control over new fire in oil tanker. And now for all the details. India and China have accused each other of firing in the air during a new confrontation on their border in the Himalayan region of Ladakh in a further escalation of military tension between the nuclear-armed nations. This comes as military commanders and diplomats have held several rounds of talks since July to reduce tension but have made little progress.
The Indian Army on Tuesday rejected China's People's Liberation Army or PLA claims that the Indian troops in Ladakh attempted to transgress into the Chinese territory along the border on Monday night that led to firing and skirmish. Dismissing the allegations, the Indian Army said, the Chinese Army fired in the air and were trying to close in on Indian posts along the line of actual control or LAC. It is the PLA that has been blatantly violating agreements and carrying out aggressive maneuvers, the Indian Army said in a statement. The latest incident comes as military commanders and diplomats have held several rounds of talks since July to reduce tension, but have made little progress.
Indian Army has further stated that in spite of grave provocations by Chinese, we have shown restraint and extreme maturity. This notwithstanding, we are absolutely standing by to ensure the homogeneity and integrity of the nation is maintained. We want all issues to be resolved peacefully, but the ball game has to be played by both the sides.
Meanwhile, the personnel of Indo-Tibetan Border Police were seen undergoing fitness checkup in Leh in India's Union Territory of Ladakh on Tuesday before departing for various forward postings. The new developments have renewed tensions in Ladakh, where 20 Indian soldiers and unverified number of Chinese troops were killed during a violent border face-off on June 15, after hours of hand-to-hand fight in the Galwan Valley.
India recorded its highest daily deaths from the coronavirus in more than a month on Tuesday, even as new infections slowed. India's health ministry stressed that more than 70% of the deaths occurred due to comorbidities. Meanwhile, amid rising cases, authorities say the soaring numbers reflect high rates of tracking, tracing and testing and that the situation is under control. India recorded its highest daily deaths from the coronavirus in more than a month on Tuesday, even as new infections slowed, data from the health ministry showed. The health ministry said 1,133 people had died of COVID-19 in the last 24 hours, the highest since July, taking total mortalities to 72,775. But new daily cases were at 75,809, the lowest in a week, even as more services and businesses reopen across the country. Western Maharashtra continues to be the worst affected state in India. India says the soaring numbers reflect higher rates of tracking, tracing and testing and that the situation is under control. But doctors warn people have become careless and dropped their guard. On Monday, India crossed the 50 million mark for coronavirus disease tests as 1.09 million tests were conducted in the day until midnight. While metro services resumed in many states under the new unlock guidelines on Monday, some experts indicate that India is facing a second wave and added that the COVID-19 curve may not flatten very soon. In news from Pakistan, the Islamabad High Court or IHC on Monday expressed serious concern over the rising number of enforced disappearances in the federal capital and directed the Interior Secretary to take up the issue with Prime Minister Imran Khan to devise a policy for protection of the fundamental rights of citizens. IHC Chief Justice Atar Minalla made the remarks while hearing a petition seeking recovery of Sajid Gondal, the Joint Director of Securities and Exchange Commission of Pakistan, who is feared to have been disappeared. The justice said there is no reason for state and courts to continue if they cannot protect citizen rights, as officials fail to give satisfactory explanation about progress in tracing him. The court ordered if Gondal is not found before September 17, then Attorney General shall appear before the court to assist in identifying the responsible functionaries and their accountability. Moving on, locals and activists in Pakistan-administered Kashmir held a massive protest and torch rally on Monday night against the proposed construction of dams by Pakistan and China in the illegally occupied territory. They blame the rampant destruction of natural resources has already led to water shortage and climate change in the region.
A massive protest along with a torch rally was held in Muzaffarabad city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Monday night against the mega dams proposed to be constructed by Chinese companies on the Nilam and Jhelum rivers in the illegally occupied region. Pakistan and China recently signed an agreement for 700 megawatt Azad Patan Hydel Power Project and 1,100 megawatt Kohala Project on the Jhelum River. The protesters highlighted that Muzaffarabad has already been facing a severe water shortage and a rise in temperature due to the diversion of River Nilam to construct the Nilam Jhelum Hydropower Project, which has made their lives miserable. They expressed anger over high Chinese presence in the area and blamed that Pakistan and China have been jointly plundering the natural resources of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan in the wake of China-Pakistan economic corridor. The resentment in the occupied territories is high against both Islamabad and Beijing.
In news from Afghanistan, at a time when Afghanistan's warring factions are set to begin their first direct peace talks in Qatar soon, Afghan government said the preparations for the negotiations are being finalized and that the delay is due to preparations still being made by the Taliban.
Spokesperson to the Afghan presidential palace, Sadiq Siddiqui, has said the preparations for the intra-Afghan negotiations are being finalized and that the delay is due to preparations still being made by the Taliban's negotiating team. Siddiqui in a statement said technical issues and preparations are almost complete. We hope that the Taliban also finishes their preparations so that our delegation can travel to Doha. The statement comes at the time when the Taliban recently announced a 21-member negotiating team led by the group's Chief Justice, Maulvi Abdul Hakim, with former Chief Negotiator Abbas Tanakzai now serving as Hakim's deputy. The peace process stems from a February agreement between the US and the Taliban to withdraw American troops from Afghanistan and close the longest US war. The landmark accord was negotiated and signed in Doha.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on Monday issued a call to discard the term martial law from the military lexicon. Her message suggested she had managed to establish political control over the military. Bangladesh has been vulnerable to martial law since its independence in 1971. It has witnessed numerous coup attempts, some of them being successful.
Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on Monday called for discarding the term martial law from military lexicon, saying it never brought any good to the country or the armed forces. "We should exclude martial law from military terminology as it never brought any good but bloodbath for the country and armed forces as well," Hasina told an audience that included top generals as she addressed a virtual meeting of the Armed Forces Selection Board. Hasina was referring to the 19 coup attempts that took place during the military rule of Zia-ur-Rahman, who had taken charge of the country using provisions of martial law in 1977. Bangladesh has been vulnerable to martial law since its independence in 1971, witnessing numerous coup attempts, some of them successful. Hasina's family has been the biggest victim of the army's interest in running the government through martial law, which suspends regular laws. Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, Hasina's father and Bangladesh's first democratically elected leader of the government after independence, was killed along with 18 family members in a coup in 1975.
The Sri Lankan Navy on Tuesday said it has better control over the fresh fire on the loaded supertanker of the island nation and is looking for any signs of potential oil leaks from the ship. A fire broke out on 3rd of September in the engine room of the very large crude carrier and spread to the bridge of the vessel, killing one person. That blaze was doused on September 6.
Sri Lanka has better control over a fresh fire on the loaded supertanker of the island nation and is looking for any signs of potential oil leaks from the ship, the Sri Lanka Navy has said. A fire first broke out on September 3 in the engine room of very large crude carrier New Diamond and spread to the bridge of the vessel, killing one person. That blaze was doused on September 6. However, new flames erupted on Monday. According to the Lankan Navy, the reignition of fire occurred on the right side of the vessel near funnel at the rear and is not near the tanks carrying crude oil. Sri Lanka has deployed scientists and experts from its Marine Environment Protection Authority to assess the environmental damage caused by the fire.
Businesses near the India-Nepal border have been hit by the COVID-19 induced lockdown. Shopkeepers and traders on the Indian side said before the lockdown, customers from Nepal and other foreign tourists used to visit their shops and help them make profit, but now they are incurring huge losses as the border is still closed and people's entry is not allowed.
Coronavirus pandemic is giving a hard time to businessmen and shopkeepers at the India-Nepal border as the sales have drastically gone down in the absence of customers from across the border. With the borders being closed and no customers from Nepal being allowed to come to the Indian side, shops wore a deserted look with no customers seen on Monday. Shopkeepers said they were incurring huge losses as they were not able to bear the expenses to run their businesses.
हमारे सब नेपाल के कस्टमर होटल व्यवसायी जो वहां से हैं वो आते थे खरीदारी करने वहां के लोकल कस्टमर जो आते थे खरीदारी करने इस टाइम 6 महीने से कोई भी ग्राहक नहीं आ रहे हैं टोटल के टोटल हम लोग का पूरा व्यापार जो है इस समय चौपट है यहाँ पे खर्चे ज़्यादा हैं भाड़ा है स्टाफ खर्चे हैं मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट है इस समय कुछ भी नहीं निकल पा रहा
जब बंदी नहीं रहती थी तो यहाँ रोज़ हज़ारों की संख्याओं में नेपाल के कस्टमरों का आवागमन रहता था और यहाँ फॉरेनर्स का भी काफ़ी आना जाना रहता था जिससे कि यहाँ का मार्केट बहुत बढ़िया चलता था और बहुत बढ़िया यहाँ का रिस्पॉन्स था मार्केट का जो कि इस समय एकदम बंद है और कम से कम कुछ नहीं तो यहाँ हजारों की संख्या में लोग बेरोजगार हो गए हैं।
This comes at the time when India has logged the world's largest daily case load every day for almost a month as Indian government pushes to open the economy to prevent further damage from the pandemic. The country has so far confirmed 4,280,422 COVID-19 cases with 72,775 deaths.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India, China accuse each other of firing in the air on tense border. Protests continue in Pakistan-administered Kashmir against illegal construction of dams. And Sri Lanka says has better control over new fire in oil tanker. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.